So you've been hearing stock up on food, create a food storage, long-term food storage, short-term food storage, a two-week emergency food supply, a 72-hour kit. Whew, oh my goodness, it could be so overwhelming. It is baby steps, it's not a marathon. So please, once you see this video, I hope you get the sense that you don't have to go out and panic shop. The whole idea of 3 months storage is to have on hand what you need when a crisis comes. Now, it doesn't mean it's always gonna be a natural disaster or a new virus coming through, or it could be a loss of a job. Sometimes it could take up to 3 months to find a new job. It could be that someone ends up getting sick, or you have to stop what you're doing to help a family member for a season with sickness. It could be any of these types of crisis. Now, you have fire insurance on your home. Some of us have earthquake insurance on our home. You have home insurance, you have life insurance. Why wouldn't you have food insurance? Okay, first off, do what you can afford. Make a budget. It could be $20 or $30 per person in your home for the month just to bring in some extra food supplies. And you're probably thinking, what do I buy? You buy whatever it is that you're already buying for your family. I have a saying that I always say is, store what you eat and eat what you store, and this will help you. So a 3 month food supply of food is things that you already normally eat, or things that are already in your normal diet, including your canned goods, your box goods, maybe some of the food that you buy for your freezer that you eat on a normal basis, commercially packaged food, things that you already go to the grocery store for and bring in. These are the items that you rotate often, and that can last 3 months. What do you already eat? What are the meals, your dinners, your lunches, your breakfasts that you always go to? May I suggest that you sit down and you write down all the meals and things that you already eat. I have my go-to meals that I make all the time and that I actually make into freezer meals. So right now, when I'm filming, it's September. From now until the end of the year, sales are awesome for food. I mean, you've got your Labor Day sales on food. You have your Christmas, your Thanksgiving. Things are on sale, and this is a great time to stock up. So let's say, okay, I love our corn chowder. Okay, it's starting to hopefully cool down, right? We love our corn chowder. I triple that recipe to feed my family. I'm gonna need 36 cans of creamed corn. Also, 36 cans of cream of mushroom soup. For my shepherd's pie that I make all the time and love to freeze, if I were to put that in our weekly rotation for 3 months, I would need 24 cans of green beans, 24 cans of tomato soup, 24 cans of corn. So you could say, okay, this month, with the budget that I have, I'm gonna focus on cream of mushroom soup and cream corn. Let's talk about short-term foods. These foods have a 3 month up to a 10-year life. So for example, box breakfast cereal has about a year shelf life, but a can of corn has 2 to 5 year shelf life. Long-term food storage can last you 20 to 30 years. These are foods that have been carefully sealed, have oxygen packets in them, but not always. A lot of these foods are also very dry foods that are not oily. But I always suggest to have beans on hand, rice, flour, oils, sugars, oatmeals to have on hand to rotate. I'm gonna have a link below for you to nab this list here for a 3 month food supply. It's a great idea, it's a great base. This helps me a ton. Okay, so this suggested 3 month food storage plan is for one adult. Okay, go through the list, look it over, and put a check by any of the items that you eat now or that you might consider using. Cross off those items your family does not like or can't eat because of allergies or medical conditions. Now you're gonna see references to like LDS cans. Our church has canneries where you could go and buy cans for your food storage, and I'll leave all that information down below for you. But there's a lot of suggested items on this list. I suggest that you start off with things that you already are used to and are consuming. We enjoy raisins, but we don't go through them fast enough. Do I have a 3 month supply of raisins? No, I don't. It's not something that we are going through quickly. My kids don't reach their hand in here and grab a hunk full of raisins. This is actually mostly for baking. So for me, I know I only need a container. And if I'm running low, I'll grab another one and store it good. Pancake mix. Just add water mix, the Christie's. Love this stuff. I get the big bags at Costco. Love it. My family goes through this like crazy. It's something that my kids can make without me having to like monitor or help them. Just add water. make it the consistency you want and just add water. This is a great, great 3-month food storage, or even longer, long-term freeze storage, as long as you know how to store it correctly. That video is coming. So I already have 3-month supply of the pancake mix here in my home. After a while of doing this, you start to recognize what you eat and what you use up, and it's so natural to you. You'll know when you're grocery shopping and you're like, oh yeah, we've already used that, that's low. Like, it comes like natural to you, it really does. May I suggest that maybe if you look into a food saver machine, these are awesome because you can use them for your everyday shelf or your long-term food storage. I was using mine like religiously for a long time, and I don't know if I got burnt out, I don't know. And then I got lax and hadn't used it much. I'm back on using it again. So you can make your everyday food that you rotate through, like in your normal pantry on your shelves, last longer. If you seal it right, you're golden. So get containers that you can seal things tight. So there you have it. You'll start to create your own rough draft of meals that you have on a, like a weekly basis. That's how I figure out how much I need for my food storage. Then when I see sales, I stock up and put them in the rotation. So I put newer items in the back and bring the things I already have forward, and this is how I rotate. To figure out how fast you rotate through something, when you buy something, you could take a Sharpie, write the date on it. But the key here is rotating. Rotate, rotate, rotate. You are eating off your 3-month supply of food. And no, it's not hoarding. Hoarding is when you just go and buy whatever off the shelves. You don't use it, you have it to have it. Don't be a hoarder. This is feeding your family. So you shop your home instead of shopping the store. Now this was supposed to be another bathroom for a pool that my in-laws never put in. So we made this our food storage room. And this is my go-to grocery store. So we have here some Gatorade. I'd like to get another one, especially when it comes to the cold seasons and people start to get sick. I like to have that juice on hand, especially if you have anybody that gets low blood sugars. It's good to have some juice on hand. All right, my children love ramen, and so I have 2 cases here. This will last 3 months, but there is great ways to turn ramen into some wonderful dishes. And then we have some chicken broth here. I love getting this at Thanksgiving time along with the beef broth. This goes on sale and I love nabbing that. It's good to have for your short-term and long-term food storage, but may I suggest that you get bouillon. This will last a long time. It's best by October 21, but if I notice I'm not getting through it fast enough, I could put it in a food saver bag, seal it up with my machine, and this will last a long time. All right, I have my cream of mushroom soups, my cream of celery soups that I use for my go-to recipes. One is stroganoff, one is the corn chowder, tomato soup, that's for my shepherd's pie. We go through ketchup like milk, you guys. My kids absolutely love it. So this is not a 3-month supply of ketchup, but it's just not. But we go through it quickly. So every time I'm at a bulk store, I grab more. If I see it on sale with the like Labor Days, like summer sales and things, I grab ketchup. But we go through it so quick, you guys. I have some barbecue sauces, some dressings that go with certain meals that we have, mayo and Miracle Whip. We're getting into some baking things. Peanut butter. Peanut butter is something that is so good to have in your long-term storage. It's such great proteins. Tuna fish lasts a long time. So canned chicken is a great thing to have on hand. And you can also find canned beef as well. Okay, we go through beans a lot. I have lots of recipes that call for beans. So we like to do our Boston baked beans. And so I like to have the original baked beans here. And we go through pinto beans and black beans and kidney beans for a ton of our recipes. So I'm constantly buying and rotating these. These go very quickly. Along with our tomato sauces and diced tomatoes, pasta is great to have. Pasta is a great meal. You could add things to it, add lots of protein to it and veggies. So, and also mac and cheese is a great staple to have on hand for the kids. And you could also add to mac and cheese. But pasta, lots of pasta.
And then I have our canned green beans and corn. So you may notice that I'm low on corn, but I did buy another box at Costco. It's right here. But here's my green beans. So we love our green bean casseroles. We love our minestrone soups. We love our shepherd's pie, and it calls for this. So as you can see that I am low on my cream style corn. I have not seen a good sale for it. So I'm hoping that with the sales that are coming up, I can build again my cream style corn. As you can see, I'm still building. I'm still adding on. Do not panic buy, you guys. It's going to be okay. So, of course, sugars, lots of sugar. This is my short-term sugar. I have long-term food storage sugar. You need salt and have that on hand. Utah does case lot sales. I'm waiting for salt to come out again for my long-term. So this is basically my long and short-term storage of salt. Sugars, I'm going to show you how you could store these bags to make them last longer, so stay tuned. I have that planned for you. So I have flours. This is baking flour over here and all-purpose flour. I have two more bags of all-purpose flour, the smaller ones, in my pantry, and I'm going to share with you how you could take these bags and make them last longer, so stay tuned, along with beans and rice. So these are the things that my family goes through, that we go through on weekly basis. None of this gets spoiled. We use it all. I'm constantly looking at the dates. So every 3 months, I'm looking at the expiration dates and things, and it goes into our meal plan. But this is everything that my family goes through with our meals. So every item goes to a recipe. Now also in your storage, long-term storage, even your short-term storage, having some basic medical supplies is good to have on hand. And along with some toilet paper, that's it. That's all the toilet paper I have, you guys, besides the ones that are in the bathroom, the packages. I try to keep one big one on hand. And of course, garbage bags. And don't forget your fur babies. Have food for them, extra food. So I have a bag in my pantry that we're already going through right now. And then we have this bag boy for our sweet Paige. Now also, you can build your 3 month supply of food for your freezers as well, if you have the room for it, okay? So if you want to get frozen vegetables, more ground beef, more chicken, or if you want to create freezer meals with your storage and store them in your freezer, this is such a helpful tip. I love freezer meals. I have a whole playlist of freezer meals for you. But think about your chicken, think about your beef, but think about how you can make it stretch. If you were to buy a few pounds of ground beef, how many meals can that make for your family? Or could the one meal be doubled or tripled and then freeze it and store it away? So think about also what you are having for your freezers. We go in on a cow with family, so I always have ground beef, but sometimes we go through our ground beef really quick before the next cow comes. And so we get a cow once a year. If you buy shredded cheese, you can easily freeze that. It turns out beautifully. If you freeze a block of cheese, know that you're gonna end up shredding it and using it like that. If you wanted to eat it cubed or sliced, it's not going to slice well after it's frozen. So if you wanted to slice up your block cheese beforehand, do that and then freeze it. But think about what you could also store for your 3 month in your freezers. Find a place to store your food. Now, I'm lucky to have the space that I have, but if you live in a smaller space and you're like, where am I gonna put this? Back in the day when we had one child, when we started our food storage, I took the coat closet that was in our living room out, because we could store our coats up in our room. I took that out and we added shelves in there. And then that coat closet became our food storage. You can utilize under your beds. You can utilize your closet space. If you have a closet that you're not utilizing a couple of shelves, use that. What if you have a dining room? Do you have a nice formal dining room that you only use maybe 3 times a year for like Easter, Christmas, and Thanksgiving? Well, store in there. Use that vertical space there. Maybe you could get cabinets that have doors, and that way you don't have to see all of it. Take a look at your space and see how you can make this work for you. All right, to summarize, 1, budget. 2, menu plan. 3, find a space for all your food. And 4, shop sales.
All right, any tips that you have for us, please leave them down below. Thank you so much for joining me today, and we'll see you soon. Bye.